More and more former justices and judges are speaking up, questioning the government's decision to send back Justice Joseph's name to the collegium for reconsideration. The centre has refused to accept his elevation to the Supreme Court. Justice Joseph, the Chief Justice of the Uttarakhand High Court, had in 2016 turned down the centre's order to impose President's rule in Uttarakhand. The Law Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad, in a letter to the Chief Justice of India, gave several reasons, like how Mr. Joseph is not the senior most High Court judge in India. He also cited lack of representation of several other High Courts in the Supreme Court. But what happens now? Well, according to law, if the Supreme Court collegium decides not to accept the government's views on Mr. Joseph's appointment, then that decision would be binding on the government.
A historic day for the Supreme Court. Indu Malhotra, the first woman judge to be elevated from the bar, was sworn in today. Justice Indu Malhotra hit the ground running by staying the trial of the Kathua rape case. But the crisis continues over Justice K.M. Joseph's elevation.
Today, a former Chief Justice and another ex-justice joined other legal heavyweights in questioning the government. Chief Justice T.S. Thakur, known for ensuring maximum judges being appointed, told NDTV that he agreed with former Chief Justice Lodha that the government's decision affects the independence of the Supreme Court. Its decision to clear one choice, i.e. Indu Malhotra of the collegium, but not the other, K.M. Joseph, is against the Supreme Court's past orders. The message being sent is that if any judge decides against the government, they will be opposed. In 2016, Justice Joseph had ruled against the BJP-led centre, striking down President's rule in Uttarakhand. Former Supreme Court Justice B. Sudarshan Reddy, who was recently consulted by the Vice President over the rejection of the impeachment motion against Chief Justice Deepak Mishra, has spoken on the government's decision. Referring to the Law Minister's letter citing reasons like seniority to fair representation of states as well as SC-ST communities, Justice Reddy says,
"The letter addressed by the Government of India to the Chief Justice of India is totally unsustainable and untenable. And I appeal to the Collegium to stand by Justice Joseph."
The ball is now in the Chief Justice's court.
They may not accept it, government misgivings. They may reiterate the decision to appoint Joseph to the Supreme Court, and that is binding of the government. It is law.
The Honorable Collegium, which has taken to itself the power to appoint judges, must forthwith, immediately and categorically reiterate its recommendation in favor of Chief Justice Joseph. But I think it's time the judiciary stood firm.
Senior judges say they are talking among themselves and they are looking at the developments with concern. They worry that this is an attempt to make institutions and individuals fall in line and point out that separation of powers is the cornerstone of the Constitution and that is now under threat. With Sunil Prabhu in Delhi, in Hyderabad, Uma Sudhir, NDTV.